We shall pay our last respects to him here, commend his soul to the Creator, and consign his mortal remains to the earth in keeping with our Catholic faith and tradition. And thereafter, reassembled in this basilica for offering the Holy Eucharist for the eternal repose of his soul. And indeed, we will now first the ceremony of the funeral. Last night for the funeral, after that we will assemble here again for the Holy Eucharist. Father John was born on 21st January 1970 at Kattavi Gomla in Jharkhand, today Mr. Julius and Josephine Ecker. He was the father of six siblings, three sisters and two brothers. He joined the apprenticeship at Daniel in 1989 and studied here till 1992. Prior to beginning his scholarship in May in 1992 at Nazareth Modern Seminary, he became a Salesian on 24 May 1993 and immediately thereafter began his postgraduate formation at Salesian College, Sonada, Patri. After completing his studies in philosophy and graduation, he was appointed as assistant and teacher at Catholic Ashram Jogbala, Andhra Pradesh, in 1996 to 97. Then he continued his practical training at Savio Center, simply for 1 year. Thereafter, he completed his PhD from St. Xavier's College, Kolkata, as a member of the Auxiliary Parish Community in Kolkata. Then he continued practical training at Rambos to develop for 1 year from 1999. He committed his life to God forever in the Salesian Congregation on 1st May 2000 at Rambos to deliver, and thereafter began his theological studies for priesthood at Christ Jolie College, Bangalore. Then on 19th January 2004, he was ordained a priest at Kattavi Gomla. After his ordination, he was assigned to the following places for his priestly and salesian ministry. 2004 to 2006, assistant parish priest and bursar at Bosco Nivas, Sonada. He was then also the youth director of Darjeeling Persian Deanery. 2006 to 2008, assistant principal and boarding in charge of Don Bosco Lubu, Kathmandu. 2008 to 2009, he was teacher, preparatory studies, student of PCA, Don Bosco Lubu, Kathmandu. 2009 to 2010, he was vice rector, preparatory studies, teacher, student of PCA, at Don Bosco Lubu. 2010 to 2011, he was bursar, Don Bosco Lubu, Kathmandu. 2011 to 2013, Dean of Studies at Don Bosco Seminary, Bangalore. 2013 to 2015, he was vice principal at Don Bosco Barol and Chakravarti, Nepal. 2015 to 2016, he was vice rector and vice principal, Don Bosco Barol and Chakravarti, Nepal. He joined Don Bosco Mansada Community in May 2016 as rector, principal, and assistant parish priest. That is where he was until our Heavenly Father called him back to himself yesterday, 14th May 2016. While he was being treated at Fortis Hospital, Kolkata, for severe nerve damage resulting from COVID-19. Father John Paul remains here in front of us, clothed in white, priestly garments. Remind us all that our mystic occasion is to make ourselves a clear, taught, and proper offering to God, our Creator and Father, to whom everything belongs. That our earthly existence is a lodging prepared for an eternal heavenly existence, which we shall inherit because of the death and resurrection of Christ. Let us then begin our liturgical rites with a spirit of faith and hope in solidarity with Father John's family members who have been severely affected also by the death of Father John's father and elder brother within a span of 10 days. Reverend Father John Sabaria, the provincial of Kolkata province, will preside at the usual rites here in the Basilica and then preside at the Holy Eucharist along with Father N.J. John, who represents the Don Bosco and Sara community, and Father Cyril Perpetta, the Vice Provincial of Kolkata Province, and a friend of Father John Eka, and other pastoral friends of Kolkata Province. Let us now stand up for the initial.
Thereafter, he will incense the body and also place a white cloth
I bless the body of Father John Ingram with the holy water that records his baptism of which Saint Paul writes. All of us who are baptized in Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we are buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of Father John Ingram, bearing its human imperfection. Let us pray in confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up his mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful chaplain and forgive all his sins. May Christ the Shepherd lead him safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. On the day of his baptism, Father John put on Christ. The day of Christ's coming, may he be clothed with glory. Saints of God, come to his aid, come to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God on most part. May Christ want you to take to himself. May angels bring you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to God on most part. Give him eternal rest, O God, and may your life shine on him forever. Father, into your hands we commend our brother, Father John Ingram. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life. We show you fatherly care for all of us. Welcome our brother to paradise. And help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith, and may we all make in Christ to be with you. Father John, to pay their respects to his mortal remains for the last time. Cross that is the stone on the coffin as a mark of love and respect. Thereafter we shall move in procession towards the cemetery beneath the body of Father John for burial. Further, as a reminder to all those who are attending this function through online live streaming, kindly be reminded that first we will have the funeral rites. After that we will be coming back here for the body of Jesus. Reverend Father and Johnny, Parish Bishop of Sava, the community members will continue with the last rites in the cemetery.
চলছে তো উঠবো
through and through. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though their bodies lie on the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Father John Eka will peacefully rest in this grave until that day when you, the resurrection and the life, will raise him up in glory. Then may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Since Almighty God has called Father John from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth from which it was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his own in glory. We commend our brother to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise up his body in the last day. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace.
Amen.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, and members of the Salesian family, today's funeral mass is not only an act of suffrage, but also an act of thanksgiving to God for having given to the Church so many generous men like Father John Ekka, who responded to the voice of the Lord, committed themselves to work with Don Bosco in the practice of the evangelical councils for the salvation of the young. We remember them because they are an incentive to us to continue with fresh enthusiasm our vocational journey. Father John Ekka, in his death, has brought his consecrated life to its highest fulfillment, because now he has entered fully into Christ's Paschal mystery. Death for the Salesian is made bright by the hope of entering into the joy of the Lord. And when it happens that a Salesian dies working, the souls, working for the souls, the congregation has won a great triumph, Constitution number 54. Father John, you have fought a good fight. Only the Lord will give you the victory.
Priya bhai aur bahano, विशेष रूप से फादर जॉन एक्का के परिवार वाले, उनके परिजन जो आज इस दुखद समय में उनको आखिरी विदा देने के लिए आप आ नहीं पाए और परिस्थिति हम सबको मालूम है, उसके कारण हम सबको मालूम है। हम कलकत्ता प्रांत के फादरगण और ब्रदरगण और सलीश परिवार के जो सिस्टरगण और भाई बहन जो भी हैं, आप सबों को विशेष रूप से आप भाई बहनों को हम आशा देते हैं कि हम सब आपके साथ इस दुख की घड़ी में साझा लेते हैं। यह आप लोगों के लिए बहुत ही दुखद घड़ी है क्योंकि आपने एक महीने के अंदर अपने पिता को खोया, आपके बड़े भाई विलियम को खोया और आज जोहन को, जॉन एक्का को आपने खोया है। और आज हम उनके भाई सलीशन समाज के फादरगण और ब्रदरगण उन्हें विदा दे रहे हैं। आप सब उनको आश्वासन देना चाहते हैं कि हम सब आपके साथ हैं, आपके दुख में सहभागी होना चाहते हैं और हमारी प्रार्थना है इन तीन जनों के गुजर जाने से आपके परिवार में जो खालीपन आया है उसको ईश्वर अपने आशीषों से पूरा करें और आप सबों के हृदय को सद्भावना और सांत्वना से भर दें। आइए हम इस बलिदान में आगे बढ़ें और एकजुट होकर हम फादर जॉन एक्का के लिए, उनके पिता जूलियस के लिए और उनका भाई विलियम के लिए प्रार्थना करें कि उन्हें ईश्वर आत्मशांति प्रदान करें और साथ ही साथ आप सबों को सांत्वना प्रदान करें।
Let's ask God's pardon and mercy that we may be worthy enough to celebrate this Eucharist. I confess to Almighty God and you to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Let us pray. O God, who have called your servant and priest Father John Ekka, from this life to yourself. Father of all mercy, fulfill his faith and hope in you, and lead him safely home to heaven, to be happy with you forever. Like a good steward, he looked after the treasures of the kingdom entrusted to his care, and tended the flock with pastoral love. Reward him with life eternal in your glorious kingdom. We make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good. For those who are called according to his purpose. For those whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, in order that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died. More than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Prabhu main tujhe ko
से प्रभु मैं तुझे खोज रहा, वैसे प्रभु मैं तुझे खोज रहा। सोना चाहिए मैं तो हिरण जैसे खुले है जल को, वैसे प्रभु मैं तुझे खोज रहा, वैसे प्रभु मैं तुझे खोज रहा। तू जो बन जाए श्राद्ध सुमन, तू जो बन जाए श्राद्ध सुमन, पुष्प पर जग रहू मैं, पुष्प पर जग रहू मैं, प्यासा हिरण जैसे तूने है जल को, वैसे प्रभु मैं तुझे खोज रहा, वैसे प्रभु मैं तुझे खोज रहा।
I am the resurrection and the life. Anyone who believes in me will live even after dying.
Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia. Sing alleluia to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is a hired hand and not a shepherd does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. And I must bring them also, that they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord.
I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear confreres and members of the Salesian family, the readings that we have chosen for today's celebration summarizes the life and mission of our dear Father John Ekka. The first reading speaks about the newness of life in Jesus Christ. We see how St. Paul tries to give a fitting conclusion to his exposition and argument about God's justification. That is, God from the very beginning has called us to be holy and blameless before Him. Therefore, we are all predestined to be transformed into His likeness of His Son Jesus Christ and to be glorified in Him. St. Paul is very certain of this purpose. So he states emphatically that no power, neither sin, nor suffering, nor political, or any spiritual powers can undo the assurance that comes from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The Rector Major Stremna for this year, moved by hope, "Behold, I am making all things new." Revelation chapter 21 verse 5 invites us to fan into flame the fire of hope. Rector Major says, "Faith and hope go together. Let us propose faith as the authentic path, because a world without God is a world without hope. Prayer as a school of hope and personal encounter with Jesus Christ, who saves us, and suffering and sorrow in every human life as the necessary doorway that opens us to hope. In many cultures, people try in every way to hide or silence suffering and death. However, what allows the human being to heal is not to avoid or to hide this suffering and pain, but to mature in it and find meaning in life when it is not immediately or easily visible. The Gospel reading presents Jesus as the Good Shepherd, who knows His sheep personally and who lays down His life for them. We are all aware of the Psalm 23 on the Good Shepherd. The approach of Jesus as the Good Shepherd is self-sacrificing, and it is altruistic. It contains important lessons for contemporary religious leadership. Father John Eckers, the first-time animator of his community, he has carried out this role of shepherding quite effectively. In this context, I'd like to reflect with you some of the dimensions of the heart of the Good Shepherd. And I want to comment on just three verses from the Gospel reading which we heard today, mainly verses 14, 15, and 16. Verse 14 says, I know my own, and my own know me. For the shepherd, each sheep is personal, unique, and precious. He loves each one. He treasures each one. Father John, in his community, treasured each person of his community who were entrusted to his care. By nurturing them, by being responsible for them, by appreciating them, and by encouraging them. Verse 15 says, "And I lay down my life for the sheep." The good shepherd is willing to make any sacrifice, even to give up his life for them. The good shepherd has tremendous sense of responsibility and attachment to his sheep. Therefore, he is ready to undergo any pain, any suffering, any sacrifice for the sake of his dear ones, even to the point of laying down his life for them. Father John just did that. He was willing to make sacrifice for his own confreres, giving up comforts to reach out to them. In the words of Father Katie Thomas, who called him a martyr of charity, I'd like to quote Father Katie Thomas here. "He unhesitatingly volunteered to take me to Bongao Hospital for the COVID-19 test on Holy Saturday itself. And again, early morning on Easter Monday, he accompanied me in a good vehicle he had hired and took me to my allotted room in Nithika." Thus, Father John Eckhart laid down his life for his confreres. Verse 16, "I have other sheep that are not of this fold." Good shepherd is aware that there are many sheep who are not yet part of his fold. So he longs for them, seeks to bring them back, yearns to make them part of his fold. As a genuine son of Don Bosco and as a one-year youth director of the Kursiong Darjeeling Deanery, John had this mission uppermost in his mind. Whatever apostolate that was entrusted to him, he always yearned to bring back those who went astray, those who lost the focus of their life, those who strayed away from the church and sacraments, those who were addicted to many vices. He made an extra effort to keep together all those people who were entrusted to his care. I'd like to end this short homily with a message which I received this morning from Father Samuel Mondol, the novice master. "Though John Eckhart died young, he had a fruitful life, bearing the fruits of the Holy Spirit. The Lord called him on the first day of the novena of Pentecost on Friday. He bore the fruits of peace, love, joy, gentleness, goodness, kindness, fidelity, self-control, and patience. May the Lord bless our province through his intercession. Amen." Let's now stand. My dear brothers and sisters, we are gathered here around the mortal remains of our dear Father John Eckhart. He has shared our life, believed what we believe, worked in the Lord's vineyard as a priest, laid down his life in service of his brothers and sisters in faith, and has now returned to the Father. Death does not break our ties with our brother. It only transforms them. In Christ we are united with each other, even beyond death. Let us turn to him with faith and say, Lord of life, hear our prayer.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Father, for Francis and God's holy people, that they may be in the world a sign of hope, love and life, and that they may bear witness to Christ's victory over death by their commitment to the promotion of human life and dignity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For our confrere, Father John Eckhart, who responded to call of Christ to be his disciple and priest and followed him till the end of his life, laying down his life in love and service, that the Lord may give him the reward of good and fruitful servant. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For the deceased father, mother, brother and other dear ones of Father John Eckhart, who were faithful in teaching him the fundamentals of Christian life and were generous in offering him to be a son of Don Bosco, that the Lord may bring them all together in his eternal home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For the other believing family members of Father John Eckhart, who are unable to be present here at this funeral, who loved him dearly and were also loved most affectionately by him, that the Lord be their consolation in this time of bereavement. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For all the doctors, nurses, medical staff and confreres of the provincial house who treated him, nursed him, supported him and took care of him during his long hospitalization in varied ways, that they continued in their service of life of service, they may feel the living and active presence of Christ, the healer of souls and bodies. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For all those who have worked with Father John and those who were with the beneficiaries of the pastoral work and the apostolate of Father John Eckhart, that the deeply human and Christian values that he stood for and the faith he nurtured in them might be for them a guiding light in the years to come. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For the Salesian congregation and especially for the province of Calcutta, that has been tried severely by the death of several confreres in this pandemic, that it may be sustained in its fidelity to St. John Bosco by the living memory of the confreres who have gone before us marked with the sign of faith, and that on the ongoing extraordinary visitation in the province may be an occasion for further growth and stronger commitment. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For the community of Don Bosco Monshada, in which Father John spent his last years, that the good Lord may grant them all possible graces and the blessings to enable them to work selflessly for the local people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For the suffering humanity all over the world and in a very special way in our own country due to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, that the good and merciful Lord may come to our aid and put an end to the death and suffering of people everywhere, and those who are caregivers who selflessly reach out to the others in service may be strengthened and rewarded. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered around the mortal remains of Father John Eckhart, that we may share with each of our brothers and sisters our faith in the resurrection through works of charity, justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of life, hear our prayer.
O God, merciful Father, you give us the certainty that in the faithful departed, the mystery of the death and resurrection of your Son is realized. Through this faith that we profess, grant our comrade John Eckhart, who now sleeps in Christ, the grace to rise with him in the joy of the resurrection. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Jesus Christ the Lord, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O God. We are the bread of Christ. If we be crowned in the meal of life, may we be found pure bread, united in one body with Jesus Christ the Lord. We bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O God. We are the grape of Christ. If we be crushed in the winepress of suffering, may we be found pure wine. United in one body with Jesus Christ the Lord, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O God. We are the body of Christ. We must expect a sharing in sorrow if we must rise with Him. United in one body with Jesus Christ the Lord, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O God. We are the wheat of Christ. If we be ground in the mill of life, may we be found pure bread. United in one body with Jesus Christ the Lord, we bring to you our offering of bread and wine, O God.
Pray, brother, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and for all His holy Church.
Lord, receive the gifts we offer for the salvation of Father John Ekka, your faithful servant and priest. May Christ be merciful in judging him, for he believed in Christ as his Lord and Savior, and served him with wholehearted devotion in his priestly ministry. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For even though by our own fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, when seized by the death according to our sins, we are redeemed through Christ's glory, great victory, and with him called back into life. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest.
indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving his holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John Bosco, St. Dominic Savio, St. Mary Mazzarello, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Thomas our Archbishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Father John Ecker, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body, to our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is.
Let us pray. Father, all-powerful God, we pray for our brother and priest, Father John Ekka, whom you have called from this world to yourself. May this Eucharist cleanse him, forgive his sins, and raise him up to eternal joy in your presence. This we ask you, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please remain seated while a few representatives of this assembly of believers will bid adieu to Father John Ekka's mortal remains on behalf of everyone. First of all, we have Father Joseph Pauria, Provincial Superior, who will deliver the farewell message on behalf of the Silesian province of Kolkata.
My dear confreres and members of the Salesian family, first and foremost, I would like to express my sincerest gratitude to all the confreres and the members of the Salesian family who have sent us condolence messages after the demise of Father John Ekka. I would like to, in a very special way, thank the two bishops, the Archbishop Thomas D'Souza and Bishop of Darjeeling, Bishop Stephen Lepcha. They were very gracious. As soon as they received our news, they immediately gave us the condolence messages. And most of the provincials, practically all the provincials of South Asia region, they gave us messages. The sister provincials of FMA, the sisters of Mary Immaculate, the missionary sisters of Mary of Christians, the FC sisters, daughters of the cross, they also sent us messages. And many sisters, fathers, and even some diocesan priests, I will remain ever grateful to them for expressing their sympathy and being with us at this moment. We have heard about the short life sketch of him, of John Ekka, and as well as the last journeys which Father Gilbert Chundal gave a day-to-day account. You must have all read. I would like to personally share some experience of the encounter that I had with Father John Ekka. As we have heard that on 7th January 1985, he joined the Apostolic School at Don Bosco, Hatia. It is there for the first time that I met Father John Ekka as a class 7 boy in the year 1987. And he was with me there for 3 years as I was doing my practical training. I remember him to be a very simple and honest boy. I remember the first instrument that I taught him was the bulbul, and he was very regular with the practice of that the instrument, the bulbul, and he mastered it. And after that, I remember, for we even had a musical presentation of all those who were learning that instrument called bulbul. The journey of Father John Ekka had just begun and had a sudden end with a span of 28 years as a religious, 17 years as a priest, and 51 years of his earthly life. Last October, when he was making the retreat, he had come to me for his personal chat. And there I really discovered the person that Father John Ekka was. He said that he was always looking forward to this kind of experience of attending the annual retreat, because it was his desire to renew himself, to convert himself, because he realized that there were so many things for which he need to make reparations, for which he need to turn to the Lord. And the last encounter that I had was in the last month, in the month of March, when he had come to Calcutta with some proposals about the school that is coming up, and also about the community, some difficulties, some challenges which he were facing, and some plans that he had. And I remember that he had a very detailed plan that to take the mission forward. And in this conversation, I noticed the zeal that he had in order to carry the mission forward. I would like to read a few messages now that which we have received, so that we will be for our edification. The first one I would like to read is from Father Bishop Thomas D'Souza. Dear Father Provincial, the death of our dear Father John Ekka has saddened all of us who knew him. He was a gentle person, smiling and friendly. As a religious and priest, he was very committed to his mission. I sent you and the entire province of Kolkata, especially the community at Monsada, my sincere condolence and prayers. May the Lord grant eternal rest to Father John and consolation to the bereaved family. The second one we have received is from Father Noble George from Delhi province, who was his novitiate companion. I was deeply saddened to hear the passing away of dear Father John Ekka. Father John was more than just a wonderful person and a great friend. He was always so kind, considerate and loving. Fond memories of companionship at Bandal, Siliguri and Sonada are unforgettable. He was a loving and lovable person. We lovingly called him Papa, and in turn he used to call me Nobile. I could feel so much love and acceptance in his expression. This affection was felt whenever we met later in life. He was very humble and hardworking. He loved fun and laughter and enjoyed all the fun with us. His soft laughter still echoes in our ears. He loved simplicity and was contented with everything. His passing away will not only leave a void in our lives, but in the hearts of all those who knew him. Miss you, Papa. First among us to die. Dear Papa, pray for us and bless us. You will always remain in our hearts. Then Father T.B. George from Lubu, Kathmandu, the house in which Father spent most of his priestly life as a young priest, and also from Borul, Chakragati, he spent almost in Nepal he spent almost 8 years. I'd like to read the message which is sent to us from Father T.B. George. Blessed are the gentle. In the missal on our altar, there is a bookmark, an ordination souvenir card of Father John Ekka. I believe it was left there by John himself, who was a member of this community for a number of years. On one side of the card is gentle, serene, smiling face of John. Above the photo, these words are printed. Here I am, Lord, coming to do your will. Hebrews 10:9. On the reverse side of the card is a picture of the Sacred Heart with these words printed below. Receive, O Lord, my offering, a heart full of love and gratitude. Father John Ekka has made his final offering, the offering of his life to God. He has carried out the Lord's will. His will is, love one another as I have loved you. A man has no greater love than to lay down his life for his friends. This last act of John, the last act of John was to take his sick confrère to hospital and in that process risk his own life. There is one common theme in all that is written about John in the WhatsApp messages that appeared after his death, and that is he was a man gentle, serene, soft-spoken and always with a smiling face, and I may add one, incapable of deceit. I have never heard him raise his voice or seen him lose his cool. He enjoyed fun and company. He saw the positive side of life, and he had many reasons to be happy about. He was one any community would happily welcome. In the span of a month, three confrères have parted from us. Something common to all three of them is the fact that they were not the noisy ones, nor the ones who attracted much public attention. They did not make headlines, nor receive awards, nor did doctorates. Through their silent, unassuming, gentle ways, they continued Christ's mission in some far-flung corners of the province. I firmly believe that Don Bosco's mission is being continued even today by such gentle, silent, but daring and caring confreres. They may be geographically on the periphery of the province, but they are the heart and soul of our mission to youth. They are unnoticed yeast that leavens the whole, and the salt that gives taste to community life, and the light that shows us the way ahead. In losing them, we have lost something not on the periphery, but something of our heart and soul. May they teach us from heaven and blessedness in gentleness. Blessed are the gentle, for they shall inherit the earth. Signed, Father T.B. George, Don Bosco, Livu. Whatever apostolate that John was given, the children of the school, teachers, all the staff and the parents loved him. He also loved them in return so much, so he worked tirelessly for them, even forgetting to eat the food or to take rest. From his sick bed, he was following up even the online classes. Here I would like to read a short testimony of one of her students named Barsha Poddar. Now she is doing her BSc student of fourth year. In fact, when she heard the sickness of John, Father John, she was trying her level best to get all the news and even wanted to see him alive for the last moment. I received this message just one day before that she was trying her best. Afterwards, she sent me all the Google search she did, even was able to reach the doctor, but unfortunately could not talk to her. She wrote a beautiful poem, which I will not read now, which is termed as "Your Warm Feast Paved My Way." But I would like to read the prayer which she composed just yesterday. Someone who is not just my inspiration alone, but has enlightened life of thousands of people like me, is really suffering so hard. Someone who is so kind and ground to earth has been battling for life in hospital from a month. Someone whom I call my best friend for life, is fighting the biggest war of his life. He is full of oxygen supply on ventilator. Father, you always said now, prayers can heal the biggest wounds. So it's now time for your Lord to prove that he has to make you a right and prove his existence. You never lived a moment without bowing your head down to him. You sacrificed your whole life to God and serving humanity. You have been our ideal. Soon, please get up faster. We are all praying for you, Father. You have fought so many ups and downs of your life. So this COVID is not a big thing. You need to get up. Please pray for Father John. Please keep him in your prayers. He strongly believes in prayers, and now just these prayers can save us in life. She's a Hindu girl, but at this moment she is following up this direct translation, and she had come to Bandal. She posted to me a photo of in front of the grotto, and she just told me that she is burning a candle for him. Another message we have received from Father A.P. Francis from Bangladesh. Dear Father Provincial, I am immensely pained to learn about the departure of yet another Salesian rector of our province. Father John Ekka, my heartfelt condolences to you and to all in the province on this great loss. He was indeed such a nice person, gentle, soft-spoken, while being entirely committed to his apostolate. May the Lord give him eternal rest and give us the wisdom to fathom the secret depths of his mysterious plans for our province. be assured of our prayers, Father A.B. Francis. And I would like to end by reading another message which I have received from the former provincial, Father Nirmal Gomes. Dear Father Provincial, yet another great loss in the untimely demise, such a simple and yet valiant son of Don Bosco was rich in humanity. My heartfelt condolences to you and to the community of Monsada at this shocking demise of our brother, Priest John. I was acquainted with him ever since his post-novitiate formation, when I was his formator. He has indeed left behind the fragrance of a very rich legacy of deep humanity. He was a person so lovable and loving, simple and humble, caring in little details, gentle and kind to all, very sensitive, respectful towards all, friendly, and always with a joyful smile on his face. I always had a soft corner for him because of his genuineness and warmth. The secret of his life was his deep spiritual life, as he was a God-filled person. He was a great Salesian, imbued with gifts of nature and grace. He gave a lot of pastoral joy, especially as his provincial superior. He was very supportive and grateful. As a leader, he was with the veterans, but had great respect for them, for their seniority and experience. And at the same time, he knew how to endear himself to them. He always disseminated positive energy. As a Salesian, he loved the young and had a very personal approach. I have seen this both in Chakragati and Borul, and last four years at Monsada. He is greatly instrumental in making the school in a rural place a success. This is because of his friendly and tactful approach and dealing with everyone. He always kept me abreast of the progress of the mission and the school. He was very committed and dutiful and kept every documentation in order and up to date. Today, as he is no more with us, I thank God for his gift to the congregation and the province, which he served with great dedication and love. We miss him dearly. May the risen Lord grant him eternal reward and peace for his great love and service as a shepherd to his confreres and children. Adieu, dear Father John. Do intercede for us. We will meet in the Salesian Garden in heaven. Amen.
Thank you, Father Provincial. We have now Father I.C. Jacob, Provincial Secretary, who will share with us his personal experience with the deceased confrere.
Dear confreres, dear sisters, and friends of Father John Eka, I am here to share, as Father Nobi said, a personal experience. In fact, it is a little personal. And it happened around this little photo that is displayed here. And you have seen the same photo in the graveyard there. You know, it is in the context of the regional visitation that we are having, extraordinary visitation. I had accompanied Father Biju Michael to Monsada, and then we went to visit the Auxilium Convent at Monsada. And this photo is taken the grounds of Auxilium Convent. So while Father Biju was having a little talk with the sisters, I told Father John, What about going out and seeing the sunset? It was already evening. Then he said, yes, of course, we shall go and see the sunset. And so we went out, and in the garden there we were talking, and then I said, what about taking a photo? Because we take the photos of conference like that, so. Then he said, okay, I shall stand. Then I took this particular photo, and then after the photo he asked me, is this for my funeral? I said, no, it is just for the archives, because we had to take photos for the archives. But it was in fact, God had decided that photo be for the funeral. Then after that, we started talking a few things, and then I asked him a question. You know, in your community, there are those confreres who are, the youngest one is 65 years or so, and you are just so young, and all the others are so old. How do you manage this community? How do you manage them? And he said, this simple answer, I don't manage them, I am just with them. They are all senior confreres, they know what to do, I am with them, I am just accompanying them. I think that was the best answer a rector could give. And he is a just young rector, first time, and he gave the right answer. I was just accompanying them. I was not ordering them or managing them. I think we can learn a lot from this gentle and humble person who knew also how to animate and how to lead, as Provincial said, lead the sheep. The first time I met Father John was in the Provincial House, because I was away some 10 years from the province. And also Father John, when I was here in the province, Father John was working in Nepal. So I hardly met him. So first time I met him, so to say, in a Provincial House. And I just asked him, I don't know his name, I was not recording. So I asked him, what is your name, Father? Then he said, I am John Eka. From that moment onwards, he kept me in attention. I mean, talking to him, he grabbed my attention for almost half an hour. That is because his questions to me and his conversation with me was all about his concern for me. What I was doing, how is your work going on, and all the rest. He could keep a conversation going for a long time, and anyone could feel at ease in his presence. A person who could get along with others in simple conversations, in kind and gentle ways. This is a person, the solution that I admire. And I find this greatness in Father John. We thank God for giving us this fine rector, this young leader, a great animator, as well as a great companion and a friend.
Thank you, Father I.C. Jacob. We now invite Mr. Pradeep Eka, a parishioner of Bandal Parish, but originally who hails from Father John's own village in Katkahi, someone who is very closely associated with Father John's family in the village, even here, to bid adieu to Father John and give us a parting message.
Please bear with me if I stammer a bit, because I'm not used to this type of condolence meetings. I usually shy away from this type of meetings. Many know about these things about me. But yesterday when I got a call from Father Sunil that he was searching for some of his relatives, but nobody was present here, so he gave me a call. Actually, I myself, Pradeep Ekka, first met Father John just in that main gate, near that main gate, I was a student of Don Bosco school and he had come here and my father called me from behind. It was after mass on Sunday. My father used to work here as a gatekeeper, Darwan. He called me and said, come here, see, meet your brother. He has come here as aspirant. Very good, I met him. And after a while, he was called by his seniors and he went away. So when my father returned home, I asked him, Father, how am I related to Father to John? So he said that actually in a village, yes, no. My village was just after we had to cross his village and go to my village. That is Mahuatuli and his village's name is Pujratuli. And my father said that actually they are a kutum. That means extended family, we can say. Extended family, and my father and elders, they had a very cordial relationship with each other's family there. And that was the first time, because I was brought up in Bandel. Actually, I didn't meet him before that. And after I met him, the next Sunday, he took permission from the rector here and he said that I want to go to your house. Very well, I took him to my house here in Lilibagan and he had lunch with us. And from that onwards, he became my elder brother. And we had a very good relationship. Not only with me, but with my sister and my younger brothers also. And he respected my parents as his own parents. And he used to say that they are my local guardians. I have left one father and mother in my village and they are the next father and mother here in Bandel. So that was the introduction, but I have heard a lot of good things about him here. Father Provincial was telling a lot of good things here. So I've got nothing more to say. Today itself in the morning, I had a talk. I phoned my younger brother, my cousin there in my village, and I told him to please go to Pujratuli and I want to speak to we know that his father and his brother, elder brother expired, but he has got a smaller brother there by the name of Santosh. So I told my cousin to please go there and just call me. I want to speak with them. And as his younger brother was not there, I spoke to his wife. We had a talk for about half an hour and I told her that I would be present there in the church today as Father Sunil has requested me. So in behalf of his family, and I would say my family, my extended family, I want to thank all of you all, all the fathers of these Salesians, especially those who took good care of him when he was sick. I used to get the update on WhatsApp from Father Lepcha. I haven't seen him personally. Yeah. Thank you, Father, for giving me the updates. Actually, I was also affected with COVID. I got my report on 15th. And Father John, when he was affected, he called my sister to say that he was hospitalized. That was the last time he talked with her. And my sister didn't inform me because I too was affected. But when I came out of quarantine, I was in home quarantine. After coming out of that, my sister said that Father John is also affected with COVID. But he's not picking up the phone now. So please find out about his conditions. How is he now? So after going through all my friends, I got the Father Lipchus number. I called him and I got the updates and I informed her that he is in such and such place. And from that onwards, I used to get regular updates from Father Lepcha. And we used to pray from him, but it's the wish of God. So I thank all of you, those who took the pains in being with him, in all his sufferings and his work. especially I thank Father Provincial also, Father Sunil, who invited me, Father Lepcha, for giving me the updates, and everybody present here. Thank you very much from his family members also. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pradeep. We will now listen to a farewell message from Father Sunil Karkata, the Vice Provincial, who was also a close friend of Father John.
सबसे पहले मैं प्रदीप एक्का और परिवार को धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूं कि आप जो कमी फादर जॉन एक्का के परिवार की ओर की थी उसका आपने पूरा किया और एक परिवार के सदस्य होने के तौर पर आप आकर इस जॉन एक्का की अंतिम विदाई समारोह में भाग लिया, उसके लिए आपको धन्यवाद। मैं दुखित परिवार के हर एक सदस्य से नम्रता के साथ धन्यवाद व्यक्त करना चाहता हूं क्योंकि जॉन के साथ मेरी दोस्ती 30 साल की थी। उन्नीस सौ छियासी में मैं अपोस्तोलिक स्कूल हटिया आया, तब मैं नया था और जॉनिका एक साल हम लोग से आगे थे और कुछ चीजें हम लोगों के बहुत मिलते थे इसलिए शुरू से ये दोस्ती हो गई और तब से लेकर जब फादर जॉनिका बीमार थे तब भी प्रायः हर सप्ताह कम से कम एक बार बात होती थी। हमारी बात ज्यादा लंबी नहीं होती थी क्योंकि फादर जॉन ज्यादा बात करने वाले नहीं हैं, कम बात करते थे ज्यादा सुनते थे और उनको अफवाहों की चर्चा में इंटरेस्ट नहीं थी इसलिए बात भी छोटी होती थी और टू द पॉइंट होती थी। जब मुझे खबर मिला कि फादर जॉन नहीं रहे तो सबसे पहले तो उसको स्वीकार करना, उसको एक्सेप्ट करना बहुत दुख लगा मुझको। मैं ईश्वर से बहुत क्रोधित था, बहुत गुस्सा लगा मुझको। गुस्सा इससे लगा कि उन्होंने मेरा एक दोस्त और मेरा एक अमूल्य भाई को छीन लिया। मेरे जीवन के अहम समय में जॉन बहुत मुझे सपोर्ट किए थे। मेरी भी एक बारी थी जब मैंने अपने पिता, अपनी माँ, अपना छोटा भाई को खोया। उस समय जॉन कहा था, घबराओ मत यार, हम लोग हैं ना, उससे मुझे इतनी साहस और ढाड़स मिली कि मैं मुड़कर कभी नहीं देखा फिर। और आज मेरा बेस्ट फ्रेंड, एक अमूल्य मित्र नहीं रहा। लेकिन इस जो मेरा गुस्सा था ईश्वर के साथ, उससे निकलने के लिए भी जॉन की ही एक बात मेरे मन में आई, और वो थी हमारी योजना से उनकी योजना अच्छी है। गॉड्स थॉट्स आर बेटर देन आवर थॉट्स। जब भी मुझे कोई चीज की टेंशन होती थी और हम लोग बात करते थे, तो हमेशा इसी वाक्य से मुझे साहस दिया करते थे, घबराओ मत, ईश्वर है, उनकी योजना बेहतर है। आज भी उनकी यह वाणी या बात मेरे जहन में गूंज रही है, और शायद जब तक मैं उनसे ना मिल जाऊं, मेरे मन में ये बात रहेगी। जो बातें उनके बारे में कही गई है, सब बातें बहुत सटीक हैं, मैं दोहराना नहीं चाहता हूं, लेकिन एक चीज मैं कहना चाहता हूं कि जॉन जैसे लॉयल फ्रेंड मैंने कभी देखा नहीं, और शायद ही मैं जीवन में अनुभव करूंगा। जब मेरे परिवार में कुछ कारणवश मेरा अभिषेक नहीं हो पाया और यहां हुआ था, तब भी उसने मेरे कंधों पर हाथ रखकर कहा था, अभिषेक जितनी धूमधाम से होती है उसका कोई मायने नहीं है, जिस तरह से हम पुरोहित बनते हैं, जीते हैं, उसका मायने है। उसने मुझे बहुत हिम्मत दिया था, और फॉर्मेशन लाइन में, बुलाहट के लाइन में काम करने के लिए भी उसी ने मुझे प्रेरित किया था। हालांकि शुरू में मेरा इंटरेस्ट नहीं था, लेकिन उनके साथ और फादर जूड के साथ काम करते करते मेरा भी लगन लग गया। मैं जानता हूं विशेषकर फादर जॉन के भाई बहनों को, जो एक भाई का लॉस हुआ है उसको कोई पूरा नहीं कर सकता है, जिसे मुझे लग रहा है कि मेरा एक मित्र, मेरा एक भाई मैंने खोया है, उससे कहीं बेहद ज्यादा आप लोगों को लग रहा है। लेकिन मैं आप लोगों को आश्वासन देना चाहता हूं, जो चीज मैंने शुरू में कहा कि हम सब फादरगण आप लोगों के लिए प्रतिदिन प्रार्थना करेंगे, और जो आपके हृदय में खालीपन है उसको हम प्रार्थना करेंगे कि ईश्वर भर दे अपने प्यार से, और अपनी सांत्वना से। और इस महामारी के समय भी आप सबों को ईश्वर सलामत रखे, खुश रखे, और आपके बच्चों को अपने भविष्य बनाने के लिए, उजागर करने के लिए, जो जिस तरह जॉन अपनी तरह से उन्हें मार्गदर्शन करता था, वो पवित्र आत्मा उसका काम करता रहे, इसके लिए हम सब प्रार्थना करेंगे, और हम सब एक साथ आप सबों के प्रति आभारी भी व्यक्त करते हैं। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू फादर सुनील, वाइस प्रोविंशियल। Lastly, I invite Father N.J. Johnny, member of Salesian Community of Mansada, to bid adieu on behalf of his community to Father John Eka, who was their rector.
Dear Father Provincial, Father Vice Provincial,
My dear confreres, sisters, friends of John, and other brothers and sisters present here. Those of us who have our SDB Kolkata WhatsApp probably will have read that beautiful journal of journey written by Father Gilbert from the time he reached Nitika and then till yesterday. But that journey began actually on Holy Saturday, 3rd of April, around 10:30 in the morning. Being Holy Saturday, Father John and I were in our private chapel praying and preparing for the evening service, vigil service. And all of a sudden we got a call from Father Thomas Katie, who was not keeping well. He said he wants to go for a COVID test. As soon as John heard that, he jumped up from the kneeler and he rushed upstairs, because this was never talked in our community. We never even felt the previous couple of days Father Thomas was not keeping too well. And then by the time I came out of the chapel, Father John was bringing Father Thomas down. Father Thomas was so weak, he really couldn't be on his own. He needed support. And then they went off to Bonga Hospital, where we already had contacted someone for doing the COVID test. They came back after the test, and Father Thomas was found positive with the corona. And the doctor advised Father John to remain quarantined because he was close to Father Thomas. The next day was Easter Sunday. On Easter Monday early morning, Father John took the initiative to bring Father Thomas to provincial house Nitika. And then Father Thomas, who was so seriously sick, he had other complications. He got well in a matter of 2 weeks or so. And John, who contracted almost 100%, we are certain, from Father Thomas corona, gradually began to sink little by little. And as the journal shows, the end came yesterday. Yesterday evening, we three of us, Father Thomas, Father Francis, Father Matthew Panapure, and myself, had a requiem mass, and we had some deep sharing regarding our confrere, Father John. Father Thomas summarized this and put it in our WhatsApp group. Some of you may have read it. For the sake of others who did not read it, I just want to read that out. We shared among ourselves the many sweet memories we have of him as a truly human, loving, compassionate and caring person. Simple and soft-spoken, who really loved the children, staff and parents, and all he came in contact with him. The children will miss the living Don Bosco that he was in their midst. We all will miss him so much. We prayed so much, and so many joined in our prayer for his healing and return to Don Bosco Monsada. But the Lord said, his mission here below is over. I am well pleased with him, and I want him now to enjoy eternal bliss with me. And so together we all say, let it be so, that your life will be run, Lord. Father Thomas put these words together, listening to all of us, and some of us shared how Father John was so available to the parents that he would change the rules if needed. He would meet them at any time. He was not that kind of a principal who would meet only that particular office time. Even on a Sunday he would meet them. Children could just walk into his office, not only to sign the diary, even otherwise. During this lockdown, one of our confreres noticed that some parents really cannot, being in the rural area, manage online classes. They would come with their child and with their mobile, and one of us noticed one parent stayed the whole day to teach them, or rather to learn how to operate and how to manipulate this contraption. And he didn't manage to learn. The following day he came, and Father John was patient enough to again help this family. There are umpteen stories that we can narrate similar to what I said. There was a case in which we had decided that a particular staff may not keep him, not because of anything bad was there, but simply because he didn't have the qualification. But this man came and he said his real situation with this lockdown, and then John changed his mind. That was the kind of man John was, who could understand, who could empathize with parents, students, teaching staff, supporting staff, support staff. Another confrere, Father Francis, who is here, he shared a very beautiful incident, very simple but very touching. He came in new member as our community, and then it was lockdown and no children, but two families came with two of their wards to meet Father John. And Father Francis was just walking in, and then these two kids, seeing Father in cassock, they've never seen him, came and caught Father. You know, these kids did not feel that, although he's a new man, he's a stranger, because that was the way John had trained children to be with us. Children would come around all of us. That's because he was Don Bosco among them. He had that Salesian presence right through. Sometime I would also get a little upset because he would not come to when I call him to my center, the DBIC center. He was so involved in the school. Putting aside that captured the heart of our children, our parents. Personally, I have seen John would call students on Saturday, which is a holy day, who are weak in the higher class. Higher class means we are only class till class 5 right now. Class, those days, class 3, 4, 2, 3. And he would give them personally coaching. That was the heart of this man, this educator, the heart of Don Bosco. I was with John for the last 4 years, working with him, looking after the parish and the DB Tech. Though we had differences of opinion, that remained when and where we talked. But after that, we are back to our normal life, communication and communion regained. Maybe it's simply because of that one quality what Father Jacob a while ago said, I don't manage them, I just am with them. And I could vouch that what Father I.C. Jacob has shared here a while ago. I must say something without Jacob's permission here. The same visitation time when Father Jacob was accompanying Father Biju, we were at table joking and laughing and having enough fun. Jacob said, your community looks externally a happy community. I said, yes, externally we are a happy community. If you want to know our internal life, you stay some longer time. I didn't mean to say that there is something wrong. In fact, John could keep us in that manner. Although there was some little difference here and there, we would come back. We would come back to the same table. Supper time was our time together because of our different type of apostolate. So that's how he led our community. He led our community being with us. Another part of his life which nobody said, I would like to share here. He was not very fluent in Bengali and he was finding difficult to read Bengali. And yet, he would be available for Sunday masses and other masses if needed on an emergency basis in the parish. That was the kind of pastor that he was. On behalf of the parents of our school, some of them were asking whether they could come and join today's funeral. On behalf of the students who definitely miss Father John, on behalf of the teaching staff, some of them really wanted to be here today, but because of the COVID restrictions, could not come. And the support staff, and on behalf of our four of us Salesians, John, we want to thank you, which we could not express earlier, for who you have been to all of us in these last 5 years at Don Bosco Mansada. We thank God, all of us together, the community, not the Salesian community, but this larger community of Monsada, for giving us such a good Salesian priest who had no other agenda. And that I can say from my heart. I have not seen in him any other interest, any hidden agenda. We, all of us together, thank the Provincial House, for the Provincial, Vice Provincial, and the Nitika community, particularly Fathers Gilbert, Father Lepcha, Father Jijo, Father Nirmal, and those other confreres who took care of him. They took our place in these days when John was suffering. We want to thank the doctors and nurses of Mercy Hospital and Fortis Hospital for being with John in these last days of his journey on earth. We want to thank the Basilica community and the Don Bosco community for arranging his very last moment on earth in such a beautiful manner. Though we did not have the large community, it was done with the due respect and what was needed. We thank all those in any way assisted John, whom I may have left out. In any way, we thank all those people who prayed for John. We know that so many were praying, so many groups were praying. People who did not know him personally were praying for him. People abroad were praying for John, our benefactors. We thank them all for being with us at this last moment of John's life on earth. Thank you, John, for leading us, the community, the larger community of Monsada, with your life, being with us. Thank you for laying down your life for one of your confreres. Jesus said, a man can have no greater love than to lay down his life for his friends. You have laid down your life for one of your Salesian friends. As Father Thomas so beautifully said, you are a martyr of charity. thank you for leaving such legacy behind. Adieu, till we meet at Jesus' feet.
Now we have the final blessing. After that we have the recessional hymn, during which we shall proceed to the grave of Father John Eka and light candles on the tomb, place flower bouquet, and pray for the repose of his soul. Kindly stand for the final blessing.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace and joy of Christ. Thanks be to God.